Hey YouTubers, welcome to another episode here on ESGNet of MLB 13 Road to the Show with Theo Bonds. And in this episode, we are going to play against the Las Vegas 51s, who are the AAA affiliate of the New York Mets. But before we get to that series, we are currently on, the Redbirds are currently on an 8-game losing streak. Yes, an 8-game losing streak. There you see, we're still, with those 8 games we've lost, we're still keeping our head above water for first place in the American North division there in the Pacific Coast League. So let's go ahead and get to the game right now. We're coming in as Theo is getting at bat here as a pitch hitter. And you see the score 2-1, bottom of the 7th, 1 out, and the bases are empty. So we'll see what Theo can do. As of lately, he's been doing quite well at these pitch hit at bats, coming in and getting a home run or a single or a double or something like that to get the rally
so
started.
We're going to see a pinch hitter here with the bases empty and
get the
one
win.
Gone
so
in
we'll
the
see
inning.
What he can do at this at bat. As you see here, he got his bat and he's ready to go. Coach is like, "Hey, I need you up there. Need you get me a hit here." So there you see, strikes out at that at bat. So, a poor at-bat right there on that strikeout. So, he only gets that one at-bat.
And I think they were just hoping that maybe they could send a guy up there that might run into one off
the rest of the team could do.
Maybe inject a little life into this ball club. So much for that idea.
So, there you see. Yeah, a nasty. I don't know what he was swinging at right there. But here we go ahead and simulate the game here. Like I said, we're on an 8-game skid. Could possibly go 9 if we lose this game. And we'll see what Redbirds and Theo can do in this game. So far, it looks pretty well. They're still holding a lead by a run, and the final score of the game is 2-1. So we do end our 8-game skid with a win. There you see Mitchell Boggs earns his 39th save of the year. And there you see his Bonds at bat that he only had in the 7th inning there, coming in as a pitch hitter. So we went 2-1. Bonds went 0-1, and a batting average still above 400 for the year, and doing quite well. As you see here, his stats for the season as far right now: 22 home runs, 52 RBIs, and a 408 batting average. He's already had 125 at bats so far in this shortened season in AAA. So we'll go ahead and move on to game 2 of this series. And there you see a home record, 34-30, and a road record not doing too well on the road, 22-29.
MLB The Show's tour of the minor leagues continues as we make a stop in the 16-team Pacific Coast League.
Win
tonight,
those games,
the second of four
from home
between
stadium.
The Las Vegas 51s
and, shows,
and the
that
Memphis
you,
Redbirds.
You know, you're a good playoff team when it comes, to that. If you don't get the chance to have the series start off at home. So, road record's always good. But you see our that bat right there, an out. An easy pop up for the catcher right there. So, Bonds 0-1 now to start the game. Again, him and the team have been struggling here as of late.
We'll check out
hopefully
that
with that win
pitch
that they
again
got
show
the night before,
this pitch
the team
is up around
and him
the letters and you'll see that back
can get
elbow drop
back
down
in the winning
a bit,
ways. There you see the show motion.
The
Bonds
gets
one right under the ball and ends up pops it up. So, bottom of the third, we're down by a run. 1-0 pitch, and there you see a nice chopper right there, but chops right to the second baseman for an easy routine out. So there you see Bonds have his head down. No, son, you got to keep your head up. So got another at bat. So bottom of the fifth, 2 outs, runner on first. There you see he goes into the force out there, gets his the runner at second, forced out there for an easy out. So now bottom of the sixth, we're up by 3. And there you see a home run right there. 2-run shot for Theo Bonds. Or excuse me, a 3-run shot for Theo Bonds there. Theo brings his boys on home there. And there you see Las Vegas thinking, man, this kid is a phenom. This kid, why is he probably thinking, why are you playing with this many home runs and RBIs, why is he playing AAA? He should be going to the majors by now. So there you see, you'll see the replay here. Bonds, I mean, he gets all that pitch right there, right in the near the in the zone right there across the belt line. And that ball is long gone. Home run, 424 feet right there. And that, yeah, right there, that is a souvenir for the fielding crew for this for the Redbirds. So 12-3 in the bottom of the eighth. There you see a nice lead for the Redbirds. And Bonds gets on base once again for a single right there. So now he's able to have someone knock him over and bring him home. With this
and at
big
this point,
right now,
I don't think you could expect anything less than a two-hit ball game.
There you see a replay right here.
He's been as high as anybody lately, and he comes
takes that
again
ball
here.
Right back where it's pitch and drives it right past the infield there, passing the shortstop, and gets a single. Still, got to work on his speed and whatnot to make him a better to get more doubles. So there you see 2 for 5 in the game, 3 RBIs, 1 home run, and his batting average just went down a point. Went down to 407. So there you see, final score 13-3. The Redbirds win it. So now, Redbirds have now a 2-game winning streak. Yeah, talk about a winning streak. 2 games. We're getting back to the right direction when it comes to being dominant on the field. So let's go ahead and get to see his, excuse me, his, there you see his overall stats for this year. 23 home runs, 55 RBIs, and a 407 average. So let's go ahead and go to game 3. And they it's a 4-game series against the 51s, which are actually a pretty cool team with a little right there, a little alien guy right there.
The show's coverage of minor league baseball
yeah,
is
game
on the air
against
the,
as
we continue
Las Vegas
our tour around the minor league.
It's a
AAA
tonight
it's game 3
of
this
4-game
set between the Las Vegas 51s
and
the
Mets
Memphis
and
Redbirds
against each other. In a battle here if we're in the major leagues. But let's go ahead and get to the bottom of the first. 2 outs, 0-2 pitch. Now you see another pop-up to bunt from Bonds to the right fielder there. So Bonds not doing too well when it comes to his first at-bats in the game. So bottom of the fourth, we're down by 4. No outs, nobody on the base. Oh, and the hit pitcher gets hit by that pitch or by that hit right there by Bonds. And actually, the pitcher, I thought he was going to be taken out, but he wasn't taken out of the game. So bottom of the fifth, runs on first and 2 outs. And then you see a routine play right there. Again, the pitcher has to get that ball and try to get Bonds out. So bottom of the seventh, down by a run, runner on second. And then you see another routine play. This time, routine from the third baseman getting Bonds out. Bottom of the ninth. Runner on third, score tie 5-5. There you see a nice single from Bonds, and Bonds moves the runner over, and possibly start a rally here.
You talk about
bottom
getting the bat head out
the
in front.
Inning. There you
this
see
right
in the replay.
The can't square
Bonds
up the
gets that ball,
any better than
that. Takes that ball right past the infield, man, beyond the second baseman. So there you see, final score 6-5. We actually do come back. The guy right behind Bonds ends up driving a run in, and the guys are able to shut the door, are able to win the game with a walk-off single base hit. So there you see, final score is 6-5, Memphis 15 hits, Vegas one error, and 12 hits for the game. So Bonds 1 for 5, and a batting average of 400. So 3 games now. We're getting back on those winning ways, you guys, for the Redbirds there. So we'll go ahead and we're going to get to game 4. There you see his stats. You guys can pause the game and see here. You see the points that he gets for his day towards his attributes. There you see 23 home runs, 55 RBIs, and a batting average of 400. So he has about a week before he gets his goals completed, which he already has them completed. So he's going to be in good shape there. So we'll go ahead and go to game 4, and they actually give Bonds a somewhat of a day off. He only comes in as a pitch hitter again And here you see, it's 2-1. Vegas leading by one. Bottom of the seventh with one out. Bases are empty, and we'll see what he can do.
So we're going to see a pinch hitter here with the bases empty and one gun in the inning.
51s. So there you see Bonds again getting a call from the coach saying, hey, need you to do some work for me. So, one out, bottom of the seventh. Score 2-1. There you see a nice line drive under going past the second baseman there to get the easy base hit.
Not too many balls hit solidly tonight. So just their sixth hit of the game. So
wanting.
Now they need to figure out some way to string a few of these together.
He's definitely showing that he's worth it. And he should be called up before the end of the season. So go ahead and simulate the game. And I did talk to Bonds about more about that, and he says that he's been getting some good positive feedback from the coaches and stuff, and the coach has been talking him up to going to the Major League Ball Club, but right now they're not really wanting to make a move yet. They still got about another month and a half, less than a month. To make the final 40-man roster. So Bonds really has to do his good job to show that he's worth bringing up. There you see 0-for-1 for the day, or excuse me, 1-for-1 for the day on that pitch hit move. Batting average of 404 for the game. So we end up losing. So now we end up losing that game. But we do win the series 3-1. So in this series, all together, you see his stats per bat, excuse me, on there. And then here's some of the points that he got for his effort there at that one at bat. So for this series, what I was trying to get to is, he is 4-for-12 for the series. Could have done a lot more better, at least when I talked to him. But there you see he has 6 more days to his goal time, which you see there he's 3-for-3 for his goal, so he's already met his goals. He just got to wait 6 days, and we'll see from the hear from the coach about him telling him a good job and what his next goals are for the remaining part of the season, which is not much left. He only has about 3 to 4 weeks left, about a month left in the season. So there you see his next training day is in within a week. And his overall stats for the season, 404 batting average, 23 home runs, and 55 RBI. So, not bad, not a bad game, but there you see his recent performance, the last 10 games there, batting. So, I'm sure Bonds, like I said, I talked to him, and he said he's getting a lot of positive feedback, but still, the Major League Ball Club hasn't really decided if they're going to bring him up for the potential postseason or not. So we have to cross our fingers and hope that he'll get called up before the end of the season. Well, that is it for this episode of MLB Road to the Show with Theo Bonds. As always, leave a like for the video, or if you're new to the channel, subscribe. I just recently got some new subscribers, so thank you guys for joining the ESGN Net family. And more to come. Check out all the other videos here on the channel. So until then, as always, keep yourselves and each other healthy. And I will see you guys next time.